Hi everyone, thank you for tuning in to this episode of Chemistry with Kat. Today we are going to be learning all about ions. We will learn what happens when an element becomes an ion, but also when a molecule becomes an ion. We call those complex ions. Let's do it. We've learned over and over again that in the nucleus of an atom, we have the protons and the neutrons. The electrons orbit around the nucleus. To have a neutral atom, you have to have the same number of protons as number of electrons. For example, carbon has an atomic number of 6, which means it has 6 protons. For it to be in the neutral state, it must also have 6 electrons. When that number of electrons changes, the atom becomes charged. If an atom loses an electron, now there are more protons than there are electrons. This element will now be positive, and we call it a cation. The easiest way to remember this is with me. My name is Kat, and I am probably the most positive person you will ever meet in your life. So just remember that cations are positive. The example I want to use for a cation is calcium. Here's the Lewis structure of calcium. It has 2 electrons in its most outer shell. Now remember our octet rule. An element always wants to have a full outer shell. Calcium can either gain 6 electrons or give up those 2 electrons and use the full shell that's underneath it. What's likely going to happen is that calcium is going to give up these 2 electrons to another element when it binds. So now calcium has 20 protons, but only 18 electrons. It's lost 2 of the negative charge, so now calcium will be written like this. And we have a cation, calcium 2+. An atom can lose an electron and become a cation, or it can gain an electron to complete its outer shell and become an anion. My example for an anion is bromine. The Lewis structure for bromine looks like this. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Bromine is a halogen, so that means it has 7 electrons in its outer shell. It only needs 1 more electron to achieve its full octet. So what will happen is bromine will borrow an electron from another atom and gain its full octet. But now bromine, with an atomic number of 35, has 35 protons, but 36 electrons. There's 1 more electron than there are protons, which means it's going to have a negative charge of 1. So we write it like this. Bromine, negative. We don't have to put the 1 when it's only 1 negative charge. And now we have an anion. A molecule is created when more than one atom binds together. This could be O2, like the air we breathe, N2, or something more complicated like HNO3. When the atoms in the molecule are different atoms, it's called a compound. So to be clear, O2 has 2 oxygens in it, so it's not a compound, it's just a molecule. A compound is something a little more complex, like table salt, NaCl, or water, H2O. It has hydrogen and oxygen in it. A complex ion occurs when a molecule becomes charged. If the molecule only has 2 atoms in it, like O2, it's called a diatomic molecule and a diatomic ion. If there is more than one atom in a molecule, it becomes a polyatomic ion. The cation and anion rule stays the same when it becomes a complex ion. Cation always means a positive charge and anion means negative. My example for a complex cation is ammonium, which is NH4. Let's draw the Lewis structure. Nitrogen has 5 electrons in its outer shell. When it binds to 4 hydrogens, 1, 2, 3, 4, this electron will just disappear. we now have NH4, but it's missing one electron. So we write NH4 plus. And that's ammonium. My example for a complex anion is something that we're going to see over and over again in chemistry, the hydroxide ion, OH-. Before I dive in and draw the Lewis structure for hydroxide, I want to teach you a really efficient technique for figuring out how many electrons go in the Lewis structure. What I'll do is I'll look at each element and see how many electrons they're supposed to have. Oxygen is supposed to have 6. And hydrogen should have 1. Then I look at the charge. 1 negative charge means it will add 1 electron. I add these all together and that equals 8 electrons in my Lewis structure. This is pretty much foolproof as long as you know the valence electrons that each element is supposed to have. So let's draw oxygen. It's supposed to have 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And hydrogen is supposed to have 1. Now these two will bind, and then we know there's 1 more electron which will be sitting on the oxygen. So now if you count this up, hydrogen has 1, oxygen has 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. We have 1 more electron than we're supposed to have, so we write it as OH-. Now, you might be wondering how this happens. Where did this extra electron come from? OH is usually formed when water breaks apart, and the oxygen is just keeping one of the electrons from when it broke apart from water. We'll cover this a lot more when it gets to acid-base chemistry. The OH minus creates your base, and it leaves us with an H plus that is missing an electron in the solution. Always put the brackets around when you're showing a charge. Thank you guys for sticking around and learning all about ions. As always, if you have any questions, leave them in the comments or email me at chemistrywithkat@gmail.com and I'd be happy to answer all of them. If you enjoyed this lesson, please smash that subscribe button and like this video.